Here we go again with another non-proc PvP build, this time with my Stamina Nightblade. I will start with the setup showcase first, followed by two simple and effective PvP combinations. In the end, some Battlegrounds gameplay footage. But before the video starts, I know it's annoying guys, but almost 90% of my viewers did not sub my channel. Do me the favor, click on this juicy sub button. Leave a like and a comment below if you want to support my channel. Thanks. Here we go with the build. 5 Hunting's Rage on the body with 3 Impen, 2 well-fitted. As monster set, 1 Krax in Impen, 1 Balrog in well-fitted, 2 Heavy and 5 Medium. On Jewelry, Spriggan's full infused weapon damage with a Spriggan small in infused. With, of course, the Oblivion Damage Glyph. You could also go for a Sharpened or Nirn instead with a Poison or Disease Damage Glyph. And on the back bar, a Critical Repulse Bow in Defending with the Berserker Glyph. If you prefer a more tanky setup, you could use 1 Pirate Skeleton instead of Krax, or 5 Breaths in Medium instead of Hundings. Let's take a look on the skills. Front bar Executioner, our 2H Execute. Relentless Focus, which gives us 10% more crit damage with 5 stacks. And if you activate a skill during those stacks, you will shoot a powerful spectral arrow called Assassin's Scourge. And it hits too, so pretty damn strong. Surprise attack, our spammable. It stuns too if you flank an enemy. Ready for Major Brutality, Minor Endurance and a Burst Heal. Shadow Disguise to Cloak Away and 100% crit chance. Incap our ultimate, which gives us 6 seconds 20% more damage against targets. You could use Soul Harvest instead for Major Defi, but I personally prefer more damage. On the back bar, Poison Injection. Then Shuffle for Major Evasion and Snare Removal. If you prefer Major Expedition instead, you can go for Elude. Then Resolving Vigor, a strong hot. Piercing Mark for Major Breach for almost 6k more penetration. And enemy Nightblades can't cloak for 3 seconds. And look at this guys, it costs nothing. So you can literally spam it on Nightblades. And they can basically don't cloak away. Of course, Shadow Image, the strongest mobility skill in game, which gives also minor maim. And Soul Siphon as defensive ult, so if you're in trouble, you will get insta full life again. By the way, try to always stand behind the target. Thanks to this juicy passive, you will gain almost 3k extra penetration. So try to keep an eye on that. I'm an Orc here, Wood Elf would be better to be honest, but since I didn't play this char for a while, it's for me not worth it to spend more gold. Don't judge at me guys, I'm poor. As Mundus Stone, I'm using the Warrior Mundus. Lover or Serpent Mundus are fine too, depends on the playstyle. For non-CP for example, I prefer to use Serpent for more sustain. As buffered smoked Beer Hunch for extra Magicka region, which means we can use Shadow Disguise and Shadow Image more often, which is extremely important for open world PvP. But if you prefer a little bit more max stamina, you could go for the Arteum Takeaway Broth. As potions, nothing special, the normal tricep potions. And sometimes I also use the physical resistance potions here, depends on the target, on the enemy. CP wise, pretty standard with deadly aim for 10% more damage on single target, resilience for more crit resistance, unassailable for 10% AoE damage reduction, duelist 3 buff for 10% damage reduction against single target. Then the red CPs, Rejuvenation for extra sustain, Ironclad for more armor, Slippery to CC break automatically, and the Juggernaut for 10% less damage while you are CC immune. So, nothing special, guys. Oh yeah, I almost forgot it. I'm a vamp, of course. Just for the passive, Darkstalker. Ignore the movement speed penalty of sneak and decrease the time to enter sneak. So pretty nice for Nightblade. First PvP combination, start with Piercing Mark, Poison Injection, 2 times Surprise Attack, then Incap into Assassin's Scorch. If the enemy is below 30%, use Executioner. Second PvP combo, this time with Shadow Disguise, start again with Piercing Mark, then Shadow Disguise into Fully Charged Heavy Attack with Incap, then 2 times Surprise Attack into Assassin's Scorch, and execute. It's important that you light attack in between, not only for the extra damage, also to gain 5 stacks on Relentless Focus. Now, some Battleground gameplay. I played against slow MMR players here, but it should be fine to show you how to use this kind of setup correctly. If you want to see open world 1vx footage, I will probably upload some stuff in the next days. But for now, enjoy the BG gameplay first. Here ends the video. If you have some questions, type it in the comment section below. I will always try to answer them as fast as possible. I really enjoy to make these PvP build videos, so stay tuned for the next chapter called Blackwood. I will definitely upload a ton of PvP and PvE content, but for now, I will chill a bit. I hope everyone is fine and healthy. Thanks for watching. Have a nice day, my friends. See ya.